stretch. Good stretch.
Fairly short journey tonight. What are your hopes for tonight's game?
Well, hopefully we'll get at least a point, if not three out of it. But hopefully we'll get at least a point out of the game.
Are you a normal away supporter?
Yes, yeah, I go to most games if I can. Enjoy the away trips more than the home games, but you know, I like to see them as much as I can.
What do you think of the team's performance over the last, say, three or four games?
Good. I think we seem to be getting probably a more settled team, although we're getting loan players in, still getting a sprinkling of loan players. I think we've got the backbone of a fairly settled team, and you know, there's no reason why we can't get a point out of the game and hopefully maybe get 3 points out of some of these games that are upcoming.
We do our own work and we tell them exactly what's going to happen. And as it happens, that's exactly what did happen that we told them before the game. We told them how they're going to play, what's going to happen at set pieces, free kicks, corners, throw-ins. Give people positions, give people men to pick up. And we fell asleep for the first three goals minimum. And, you know, you can't do that against a good side like this, then they're going to keep coming at you. Second half, all right, yeah, but the game's done and dusted already by then. So you don't know what I really want to say about first half, but it was an embarrassment, I think, is probably the best way to describe it.
Falling asleep by players is one thing, of course, but when you look at players out there who, quite frankly, just didn't have any guts, for want of a better word, it was a spineless performance in that first half.
Yeah, I can't disagree with you, absolutely. But as I say to you, we work on things. It's not something we just throw together. And the last 4 or 5 weeks we've been doing it particularly well, working hard, shutting down people, set pieces, putting bodies in the way. And for the first 45 minutes, we did not do that at all. And got punished for it, and as I say, against a side like Easton, we're going to keep pressing at you. You know, I'm not going to say, you know, they've got the prettiest football to watch in the world, but it's very effective and they do it very, very well. And they all know their jobs, they all know where they've got to be, and we didn't counteract that. And you're going to get punished against sides like that.
You're the manager, Mick Woodward's the owner chairman. At half time, he apparently came into the dressing room. Understand his frustration as much as anyone else's. How did you feel about his input?
Mick runs the club, owns the club. He's totally entitled to come and say what he felt. And, you know, he pays the wages. And at first half, that was not what we expected from our players. And he came in and told them so. And, you know, he has a right to do that. As I say, we got a reaction second half, so obviously something worked. As I say, we're chasing the game with 4 goals. You know, are we going to get 3 second half? Very unlikely against a side that's as organised and consistent. But we had a go, which is a bit more pleasing. But as I say, it's no good chasing games when you fall down. We've done it Saturday, had a good go second half. Done it today, had a good go second half. But you can't chase good sides at Oxford and Heston when you fall down. You know, we don't pretend to be good enough for that. And to be fair, sides probably take their foot off the accelerator. So it flatters us a wee bit, but I'm so disappointed in the first half performance. You can't, you know, you really don't know.
I'm sure you're not a quitter, but how do you actually feel about your role at the moment after splitting that?
Well, listen, I'm never going to quit on anything. You know, I believe in whatever. I do, you know, but obviously at the moment if the players aren't performing, then obviously big changes have to be made. What them changes are going to be, I really don't know. But I'll tell you, you know, I'll work as hard as I possibly can for as long as I want. I know how Mick is, and he's a very passionate person. I may come across as maybe late, but I'll tell you what, that hurts me. That really, really hurts today. And I've told them so, and, you know, as I say, they've let me down as much as themselves today. You know, they talk about being good players, and if you want to perform in front of people, you have to do it on a regular basis, week in, week out, and put in performances. You can't pick and choose when you fancy doing it. And tonight, I think the first half, we picked and chose. We chose, and we just didn't come up to scratch tonight. Simple as that.